Hi, this is Wayne with Sears Parts Direct. Today we're going to talk about troubleshooting an electric dryer that won't heat. There are a few things that could keep your dryer from heating. You might have a problem with the power supply to the dryer, a broken heating element, high limit thermostat, operating thermostat, thermal cutoff fuse, or timer. I know that sounds like a lot, but don't worry. We'll help you work through them. The first step is to check to see if the dryer is getting the correct amount of power. You may think the dryer is getting enough power if the motor runs, but the heating element needs 240 volts of electricity to heat. The motor will run even if the dryer is only getting 120 volts of power. Check your power cord to make sure it's not damaged. Then, reset your house circuit breaker to make sure it's not tripped. Set your dryer to a time dry, high heat cycle and see if it heats up after resetting the breakers. If it's still not heating, we'll need to check the components on the control circuit. Checking continuity with the multimeter will allow us to test them all at once. First, unplug the dryer. For safety, always disconnect power before checking continuity. Remove the back panel from the dryer, then remove the back of the control panel. Unplug the large red wire from terminal A on the timer. Set the multimeter to read ohms of resistance. Measure resistance between the large red wire on the timer and the heating element terminal where the large red wire is connected. If you measure near 15 ohms of resistance through this circuit, then you know that the heating element, high limit thermostat, operating thermostat, and thermal cutoff fuse are all okay. You can skip ahead to learn how to check out your timer. If you measure no electrical continuity through this circuit, which is an OL on this multimeter, then we'll check the heating element. Place your meter leads on the heating element terminals. You should measure near 15 ohms of resistance through the heating element. If you measure no continuity, then the heating element is defective. This video will show you how to replace it. If you measure near 15 ohms of resistance, then the heating element's good. We'll check the high limit thermostat next. Place 1 meter lead on each terminal of the high limit thermostat. You should measure near 0 ohms. If you measure no continuity, then the high limit thermostat will need to be replaced. If your high limit thermostat's okay, we'll check the operating thermostat next. Place 1 meter lead on the red wire and the other meter lead on the red-white wire. You should measure near 0 ohms of resistance through the operating thermostat. If you measure no continuity, the operating thermostat will need to be replaced. If your operating thermostat's good, we'll check the thermal cutoff fuse next. Place 1 meter lead on the red-white wire and the other on the red wire. You should measure near 0 ohms. If you measure no continuity, you'll need to replace the thermal cutoff fuse. If the thermal cutoff fuse is good, we'll check the timer last. With the dryer still disconnected, turn the timer to time dry, high heat. Place 1 meter lead on terminal A with the red wire and the other on terminal C with the black wire. If you measure no continuity, then the timer is defective. Here's a video that will show you how to replace it. If you made it through all these checks and still haven't found your problem, you could have a defective motor centrifugal switch, a bad plug, or a defective circuit breaker. You would need to get a service technician out to check these for you. Hey, thanks for watching. Check out our other repair videos here on the YouTube channel. And if you like them, subscribe.